Welcome back to Whisper Gaming ASMR. And today, or tonight, depending on when you're watching this, we will be doing another Grand Theft Auto 5 online video. And in this one, I will be chewing some Trident peppermint gum. I'm gonna start with two pieces, and we will see. I add more as I go. Then again, I'm not exactly sure what I'm supposed to be doing in this game, so I'm kinda just following the yellow line they give me. And it appears they want me to go to a clothing store. I don't know why I'm in an emergency room, but this is where it put me when I got back into the game. And it does not look like I have a car, so I think I might need to steal one, which I believe is easy to do in this game. Oh nice, there's some just sitting here. I like the looks of this red one. Settings. It's not supposed to have any. There we go. Not supposed to have any music. Don't want to get copyright stricken. I do wonder, does this game have, like, real-world songs in it? Or are they all, like, royalty-free songs that they commission for the game? Because I remember Grand Theft Auto 3 had pushed it to the limit on one of the radio stations. And I used to just crank that when I was, like, driving around in that Dodge Viper-type vehicle. Purchase some clothes. Well, I like the outfit I already have, so why do I need to buy new glasses? Spending because I did when I bought the game on sale. I think I splurged a little bit and got the version that came with the shark card or whatever. So I did technically pay for this money, and now I'm buying stupid clothes with it. Let's do first person mode until we get sick of it. It does suck that the mirrors don't work, but I'm assuming my graphics card could not handle that. We'll pull over here. Oh. closed captioning. Successful tribute act for a very popular artist from the 70s and 80s. You definitely know the name, but like, I don't want to, like, I'm trying not to give out too much personal information about my life, but anyway, my dad knows a very, very successful tribute artist, and he fully imitates the guy and does a really good job of it. I don't know if I'd want to go that way. I don't think I'd want to, like, pretend to be Pete Seeger, but just making a show focused on his music and things like that, and that way I'd be attracting an audience that's looking for that type of music instead of just, like, playing to a random open mic audience at a bar or cafe or something that doesn't particularly like that type of music. So anyway, I really like that idea, and I'm making that my new focus. So I'm working on learning more of Pete Seeger's techniques, and I'm just gonna try to learn more of his song, give myself like 2 weeks per song, and try to start learning at least 20 of his songs to put a, ideally I'd like to get like a 90-minute show together. Even starting with like something like a half an hour or 40 minutes would be good. So I've been working on that since I got back. back from visiting my family. And anyway, a couple hours ago, I posted on a Facebook group. Oh, Jesus. I wonder what this car looks like. I posted on a musician's Facebook group looking for someone that teaches Pete Seeger-style banjo, because there aren't a ton of resources for that style of banjo online. And I've kind of struggled to find a teacher that specializes in that, so I just posted that, and I just checked, and actually had some responses and some pretty good leads to go off from. So I'm pretty excited about that. And one of the teachers they suggested, I was already actually planning on going to a jam that woman is hosting on Friday, so that worked out really well. And I think it'll hopefully help me learn these songs better and just become a better musician, and more importantly, start meeting musicians with similar interests in New York, which is something I've wanted to do for the past year, so I'm just really excited about that. I feel bad about this. Damn. There's got a lot of porn up there. This guy looks so nice. I feel really bad about this. Shout through your headset. Is that actually being serious, or is that a joke? Come on, dude. Drugs. Now we got the hooker. How do I turn off the lights? Damn. Let's give this bitch $100. God. She looks rough. Well, my controller is vibrating. This seems like it, I feel like there should be some type of warning here. Jesus Christ. Well, sorry if you aren't looking for that in an ASMR video. God, this lady is in rough shape. this vehicle will be available in future online sessions once you have it fitted with a tracker. Where is Los Santos Customs? Los Santos Customs. Am I just like an idiot? Alright, here. Okay. I was literally on top of it. Well, I guess this Hummer type vehicle will be my first car in this game. But yeah, the music thing has been the main focus. Me aside from this channel, and I'm really trying not to spread myself too thin. Oh, is that like a Camaro? Oh, fuck yeah, okay, never mind. This is gonna be my first car. I'm gonna wanna change the paint job, like. Super cliche. I don't know about cliche, but kinda lame. Oh shit. Oh, you motherfucker. Ah, oh, you bitch. I'm gonna get that guy. Unless he despawns. But like the Camaro, the old one from the first Transformers movie. Like my dream car growing up, and that was very similar to it, except not the right color. Ah shit, I think I lost him. Well, that's the car I want. Okay, new mission for this video. Steal one of those cars and go get it fitted with a tracker. Feel bad for like a nicer version of the car I have. Feel bad for whoever I find first driving that car. Especially if they're in a yellow one. Oh damn, two hookers. Things look like fucking zombies. The Mustang. Vehicles also look pretty sweet. Okay, what would be the best way to go about finding one of those? Okay, is that? Okay, that's how I shoot. Ah, that really freaked everyone the fuck out. Whoa. Okay, next time I find a car like that, I'm just gonna pull up and shoot the guy. Wow, this game really is terrible. But like I was saying before I got distracted by my semi-dream car, I'm trying not to spread myself too thin, but I also have been wanting to get into like writing again. I've been interested in starting to write short stories to publish online and trying to make, again, all these plans. I know it's going to take a lot of time. Work to eventually make money, but I really want to like eventually diversify my income and not need like a 9-to-5 job and be able to make money doing creative things like music. And this looks more like a Trans Am, but this might be. Those cars are kind of sweet, but not what I'm looking for. Yeah, I want to make money doing creative stuff that I actually find fulfilling and feel like I'm actually providing value to people instead of working in sales. So I want to get into writing as well. But I'm just worried I'm going to spread myself too thin because, like, working on growing this channel takes a decent amount of time and effort. And trying to learn music and meeting people and putting myself out there also takes a lot of time and effort. Plus, I have a full-time job. And I'm also doing some photography in my free time. Because I'm working on building a portfolio to eventually make like a photography book. And I would like to get into portrait photography and stuff, but again, there's only so many hours in the day. So yeah, ideally, I would love to make a living from performing live music slash like potentially streaming and stuff like that, but more focusing on the live performance aspect. I really hope eventually I can make some money with this channel, but I think that's gonna take a long time if it ever happens, trying to stay positive. But the more I've been learning about, the more like slightly discouraging it is, but I'm determined, so I think eventually I'll make at least some money with this channel. And then I'd like to also make money through photography and writing. And I just don't know if it's... I think anything's possible with enough work and determination and stuff. Use the photograph and the email to identify the location of the treasure. I think you can do anything if you work hard enough at it. Or at least, for the most part, like I don't think I'd ever be able to play in the NBA or something like that. Is that my car? It is. It looks shitty, but... I'm so sorry that I just had to murder you for that. And this one's kind of a piece of shit, so hopefully I can upgrade it. Wrong place at the wrong time, unfortunately. That's like a new Camaro. This is definitely a Trans Am. Yeah, fuck it. I guess that's more of a Challenger, but... Oh shit, don't fuck up my new ride. But yeah, I just don't know how feasible it is to make a living doing all of that and like work on all those projects simultaneously. Especially when I'm like kind of on the time crunch of how long I'm gonna be in New York and I wanna have a family and start having kids and stuff. Shit. Well, I guess I'll resume this conversation after I get rid of these cops. You're fucking up my ride even more than I fucked it up. No. If I, like, drive it, I remember in the old game you could just, like, drive it in the garage and immediately... Get rid of the place. Shit. Nope. Well, fuck. Hope there's no trains coming. Maybe they won't find me down here. Fingies crossed. This one definitely looks more like a Trans Am. Camaro, but whatever. It'll be nice with plug now. It'll get me through until I find the perfect car. But yeah, that's just kind of the life stress I've been dealing with lately of not knowing if all this is feasible, but I don't really picture an alternative of giving up on these dreams and stuff, so I'm just gonna keep working on it, and we'll let life take care of the rest. I'm sure I'll find my way. But if any of you have any experience in any of those areas and have any tips, I'm more than happy to hear them. Like, also, and I'd be fine with Phoenix, yeah. This is definitely like a Trans Am, Firebird, whatever thing. I don't know a ton about cars, but I know a little bit about cars. But I'm also like open to branching out to other things too. Like, I'm doing this ASMR. But I'd love to do like voice work for an animated show or something, or even like an animated short where someone is looking for like someone to do a voice for free. Like, I'm not opposed to doing stuff for free to get experience. I don't know where I'm going with this, but a neon layout. Why are these all free? Is neon even like still a thing? This doesn't look like a Camaro at all. Well, we'll take this bad boy to go find the car that I do want. Man, I don't know where I was going with that ramble. I should start titling these videos as rambles, because most of the time I'm just rambling with no point, but the overarching point is I hope that someday I can break free of a 9-to-5 job and job and just do things I find creatively fulfilling. Is everybody on the street a hooker? It looks like every other person's a hooker. did he not fall off? Okay, that thing's pretty sick. Why can't I get my gun out? All I'm doing is like flipping people off. Can I not shoot out of this car? Sorry, dude. Hey, where's the closest custom shop? Windshield fixed. This thing's pretty sick. I don't know if this would be like a Ferrari. I think it'd either be like a Ferrari or a McLaren. Maybe a Lambo. Again, I like would say my knowledge about cars is like a 6.5 out of 10. I feel like it used to be slightly higher, but since graduating college, I've stopped keeping up with a lot of things, like music, like modern music, and cars, and pop culture in general for the most part. I feel like graduating college like aged me by 15 years. This car is not going to be free to fix up and stuff, but maybe I'll be wrong. Drip. Which one of you wants to get murdered? Well, I guess I don't have to murder you, but that guy's a pussy, he just ran right off. guess I shouldn't judge him if this is real life. If someone stole my car, I would definitely just let him take it. Would not be worth dying over. Let's see if this car is not too hot to modify. Actually, the handling of this car so far. Hey, there's my car. Which one do I like better? Probably this one once I change the color of it. This video if I found my dream car right at the end when I least expected it. Guess I'll just be the one that got away. I gotta pay for this one, it looks like. Are these all locked? Nice. Holy shit. That's so much money. Do you have like a cheap? A cheap yet, oh my god, why is this so expensive? Holy shit, how much does a tracker cost? Can I sell this thing? Just like steal vehicles. Can I like call my car in? Looks like I'm stuck with old yellow then. But I think we'll grab old yellow, maybe get her fixed up and call the video there. It'd be crazy if this whole life actually worked. Where you just could leave your car in the middle of traffic and nothing would happen to it. $164, Jesus. All this shit's so expensive. That's really retro. Do I want that? I think it's kinda sick. Actually, like, spend real money and buy this stuff. That's kind of crazy. I guess that maybe it was the same car, maybe just that made it look less like it. Now it looks a lot more like a Camaro with that grille, because the Trans Am and Camaro are very similar, or at least for several years they're very similar. Those will be sick. Okay, well, I think we're gonna wrap it up here. We got a car, potentially my dream car, I can't tell, but it looks pretty cool, so I'm content with it. And in the next, well, the next time we play this, try to do more missions, unless you tell me that you'd prefer for me to drive around and ramble and stuff like that. Totally open to different ideas, since I don't know much about this game. But really appreciate you spending your time with me. I hope you enjoyed the video, if you're trying to sleep.